Peace be with you, my beloved brothers and sisters. I have a message which is as burning coals burning in my heart. A message directly from the Lord. I know. Yeshua is coming. And he's gathering his men. And he said, will be crowned with them, and they will be crowned with him. And he will come in glory, and he will take the kingdom over the whole earth. The world is going topsy-turvy. The rulers are casting away the commandments of God. And we are deeply grieved over what the governments are doing. The world is shaking. The world is built on the Ten Commandments. And if they are cast overboard, the whole world sucks down, as we see the great ocean steamer Titanic is going underwater. The world is destroying itself. But God has anointed his king in Zion on his holy mountain. And the first thing which is going to take place, that is the coronation of our Lord Yeshua, the anointed king made and set by God in Zion. And he will crown those who have borne the cross and followed in his footsteps. Holy Father, thank you for this little opportunity to share your holy word. Oh, nothing of myself, only your voice may be said. Holy God, make us ready to meet our King for his eternal glory. May your name be magnified. We are your living resurrection body. You are our head. You are our King. You are our High Priest. Glory be unto your holy name through us, blood-redeemed sinners, who were sinners. Thank you, Father, in the name of our Lord Yeshua, by your blessed Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself. Amen. This is a beautiful picture of the seven-armed candlestick, you know so very well. It's wonderful how Yeshua Mashiach is a fulfillment of the law. And what is written in Leviticus 23 about the seven Sabbath rests through the year, the Jewish year. They point forward to the Messiah. Every one of these feasts and holy days. So it points forward, first of all, the Passover feast to the slaughtered Passover lamb who was slaughtered. And he brings us into the rest of God by his holy blood. It happened exactly. Our Lord was crucified in the hour when the Passover lamb was slaughtered in Jerusalem. At the very hour when the high priest slaughtered this Passover lamb at the temple of Jerusalem, Yeshua died upon the cross because he is our true Passover lamb. Also on the seventh day of the unleavened bread, then the 15th day is the Holy Sabbath rest, the greatest. As he leads us into the rest of God in the 15th day of the first month, the seventh day of the unleavened bread, also a rest. And so the Lord has brought us into the true Sabbath rest in himself. Then comes the feast of Pentecost. Isn't that wonderful? The Holy Spirit is poured out mightily. The promise of the Father is given. And the Lord has spoken to his disciples, you shall be my witnesses when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you shall be my witnesses from Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the end of the world. And this was fulfilled exactly on the day of Pentecost, a third holy Shabbat, Sabbaton, in the Jewish year, But notice the middle of it. We, that the middle of it, it is a feast, a central feast. That is the Feast of Trumpets. The first day in the first month, this year it will be the 5th of September. And that speaks about a future fulfillment. Yeshua is coming again, and suddenly he will come down from heaven in all his glory, and the trumpet will be sounded, and the saints who are waiting for him will suddenly be changed. Those who are already changed into his likeness by the cross, they will outwardly, their bodies will be changed, and they will be lifted up in clouds and meet our Lord in the air. Yesterday you have seen many pictures of the saints in eastern countries of the world. They all greet you with the living hope. Our Lord Yeshua is coming quickly, and we look forward to the day we shall see him as he is, and we shall meet you and forever be together with you. Oh, that they are living in that burning hope, and I am living in that burning hope, and I am standing on my tiptoes waiting for the coming of our Lord. His coming is very, very soon. That will be the fulfillment of the Feast of the Trumpets, about which I read Leviticus 23 and verse 23. And Yahweh spoke to Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, saying, in the seventh month, on the first of the month, shall ye have a rest, a Shabbaton, a memorial of blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation. No manner of servile work shall ye do, and ye shall present an offering by fire to Yahweh. Last night I spoke about that offering by fire unto Yahweh. Lay your whole life as a living sacrifice upon the altar of God, which is Golgotha's cross, where our lamb was slaughtered. And God will accept us in his name. There on the altar, we are transformed into his likeness. And as the flame of the fire comes up from the altar and devours the sacrifice, and it ascends up to heaven, because the Hebrew word for burnt offering is olah, and olah literally means ascending up to heaven. So those who have laid their lives as a living sacrifice upon the altar of God, they will ascend up by the Holy Spirit, by the fire of the Holy Spirit, and they will ascend up to heaven. Isn't that wonderful? As Manoah saw the angel of Yahweh ascending in the flame of fire up to heaven. Marvelous how the Lord reveals himself in his saints, who were the deepest fallen sinners, having no worthiness of themselves, no power of themselves, no good in themselves. The Lord has transformed them first inwardly, taking out the stony heart and giving them a new, his own heart and his Holy Spirit. By faith we have received. He has made us a completely new man. He has not renewed the old man. He has not made the old man a whit better. No, the old man is crucified with Christ, for he died in our state, and so we have died. That's the main message of the Apostle Paul, which he preaches everywhere, in all the letters, in everywhere where he traveled. He preached, I am crucified with Christ, and no longer live I. That is the message, not of making the old man better. No, but when we have been crucified with Christ, then we have died. then we must be buried. We are buried with Christ in baptism by living faith, and we are raised up as an entirely new creation. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Hallelujah! The old Ulf has passed away. When I was baptized, I dipped so deep under the water that my brother couldn't pull me up, because I had only one desire: no more Ulf, that detestable creature, but only Yeshua, the anointed, shall be all in me, because he is the Alpha and Omega. And so we are new creation in Christ, and the old has passed away, and all is new. That is a saving message. That's a saving message. And we are already made inwardly a new creation. But when our Lord comes to receive his little bridal flock, what is the bride? She who loves him with all her heart, with all her soul, with all her strength. She is his bride, who faithfully follows in his footsteps, leaning upon him, cleaving to him. She, the least of all, will be lifted up, and to the marriage of the Lamb. You see, our King must be crowned, and the crown which our Father gives his beloved Son is his bride, because it is written in Isaiah 62 and verse 3, "And thou, Zion, shall be a glorious crown in the hand of Yahweh, and a precious diadem, kingly diadem, in the hand of your God." That's our high calling from the Lord. And what is Zion? In Psalm 164, it is defined: Zion is those who obey and follow the Lamb. That is wonderful. I will show that precisely for anyone interested. That is God's definition of Zion. Zion comes from the Hebrew root Tawah, which means command. That are those who do whatever he speaks. Oh, my brothers and sisters. And we are waiting for the coming of the Lord. We cannot figure it out. We can see the world is drowning all around. It is going underwater. Also, this beautiful country, from out of which has flowed more blessing than perhaps other countries, except perhaps Israel. But there has flown blessings out from America, and there still flows blessings of spiritual blessing from America. But we see what is happening. The ship is suffering shipwreck. All the ecumenical, the whole ecumenical fleet with all the boats and ships in it, all the churches joined to the ecumenical movement, suffer shipwreck. I cry to them in love, warn them, and they shake their head, and a little moment later they are swimming in the water and their boat is destroyed. My brother and sister, Yeshua is coming, and we must be ready, and he must be crowned. And before he comes in glory to take his kingdom in Armageddon, and that will be the fulfillment of the next wonderful lamp here, the sixth Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, where he will reveal himself. He will come down on Mount Olives and save his Jewish people, as many who has repented and accepted Yeshua HaMashiach, and none else. Jews who reject him and reject him, they will not also go lost. No, God has no partiality and respect of persons. And there will be judgment, and there will be salvation for those who believe. And the Lord will take the kingdom over the whole earth. And where he was crucified, he shall sit and rule as omnipotent king, as El Shaddai, as the Prince Sar Shalom, the king, the Prince of Peace, ruling over the whole world. It will be glorious, a paradise so glorious over the whole world, as is prophesied by the word of God, which has never been fulfilled yet, but it will be fulfilled. But first he must have his crown. First, and therefore he is first coming to take up his little flock. The next wonderful event on the plan of God, the last two are the first and the eighth day of the Feast of Tabernacles. That Feast of Tabernacles, which is so glorious, that speaks about the glorious kingdom of God on the earth, with peace, with abundance and blessings over the whole earth. So you see, everything is being fulfilled in Yeshua Mashiach, and the next feast is the Feast of Trumpets, and I am waiting for it, and I must just read this very important scripture, which is the voice of God directly, and that is written in Revelation 19, verse 6. And I heard as a voice of a great crowd, and as a voice of many waters, and a voice of strong thunders, saying, Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty, has taken to himself kingly power. Let us rejoice and exult and give him glory, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife has made herself ready. And it was given to her that she should be clothed in fine linen, bright and pure, for the fine linen is the righteousnesses of the saints. And he says to me, write, blessed are they who are called to the supper of the marriage of the Lamb. And he says to me, these are the true words of God. We are invited to the marriage feast of the Lamb. Even more, we are called to be the bride of the Lamb. That's the highest calling for the church of the Lord, to become the bride of the Lamb. The bride is not invited. She invites others to their wedding. That will be wonderful. In Zion, in our Father's house, like every Jewish marriage, there the marriage takes place in the Father's house, if that is possible. And so your Lord Yeshua said, behold, in my Father's house there are many mansions, and I go to prepare a place for you, and when I prepared that, I come and fetch you to myself, that you shall be forever with me in our Father's house, which is up in the heavenly Jerusalem. The wedding, the marriage of the Lamb will be concluded. And in a Jewish marriage, there the bridegroom comes at midnight time, and there is blowing shofar, not trumpets, but ram's horns, and he comes at midnight, unexpected, and his wife, if she is ready, he takes her and leads her, and they are carried in paldakin up into the chuppah, into the wedding room, where they are together for 7 days. It's wonderful. God has anointed his king in Zion, and he will gather his little bride, and Yeshua will be crowned in Zion with you who love him and follow him and do whatever he says. You are his crown of glory. And he reveals his kingdom today in his little flock which follows him. And with him we shall come in glory. As Paul says, when Christ, our life, will be revealed, you shall be revealed with him in glory. Let us therefore crown the Lord as the King of our lives. And let us do like Mary, who fell at the feet of our Lord Yeshua, as Brother Merle said. I have in my little room at home with big, big red letters written, "One thing is needful, that I may never neglect and forget the fellowship privately at the feet of my King, because he says, 'Behold, I am standing in the door and I am knocking. If anyone hears my voice and opens, to him I will come in and eat supper, the Lord's Supper, and I with him.'" Anyone who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. That's a call the Lord gave me to signal to you this morning. Thank you for the opportunity. Yahweh bless you. Holy Father, may we fall at your feet and crown you the King of our lives. Rededicate our lives completely on your holy altar, where the fire of your Holy Spirit is burning. Yes. Being united with the Lamb of God in his crucifixion and death and resurrection. Thank you, Lord. You are risen and we are raised up with you. And we are expecting our ascension up to you when you come to fetch us. Lord, Holy God, I have only one prayer. May we please you. May your name be glorified in our lives. May we love you with all our heart and soul and strength. And do whatever you will. Amen.